In this example, I want to show you how to use a query that uses numbers and currency. So these would be for number and currency data types. They actually, these examples work for either number or currency. They work the same way. So here you have an order amount field. When I run this query, it's going to show me all of the records. Actually, this is between January 1st and March 31st. But let's say I just want to get the records that are equal to $28. So we're going to pick on a view here. And then for the order amount, I'm just going to type in a value, 28. And then we'll pick on run. And notice how it's just showing the one for $28. Let's say we want all of the ones that are less than 28. So we can use less than. Of course, we can use less than or equal to. So if I run that one, well, there's two. There was one for 1250 and one for 1840. Let's pick on view here. If I say less than or equal to 28, then when we run that, then it includes 28, 1250, and 1840, as we can see. And then we can also use greater than. We'll just say greater than 28 or greater than 100. And when we run that, of course, you know, all of these are greater than 100. Naturally, if I pick on view, and there might also be, let's say, greater than or equal to 100. Naturally, we can use that. Right. So we have less than, we have greater than, we have less than or equal to, we have greater than or equal to. Let's say I want to see all of the ones that were not equal to 28. So let's. The way you do that is the less than and the greater than next to each other makes kind of a diamond there. And I'll say not equal to 28. So that'll give me every record except for the ones that equal exactly $28, as we can see. Let's go back to design view. And now with a number, we can also do a range. So let's say I want all of the ones between 100 and 200. So when we run that, first of all, because I put that criteria in the same row, the date range has to be true. And now also the amounts that are between $100 and $200. So those kind of examples will work just fine with either number data types or currency data types. It'll be the exact same thing. In this case, I'm going to end this example by saying greater than 500 when we run that. Notice how they all have to be within the date range and they're all over $500, as we can see. So now you have some examples of how to do your number type of criteria.